What's up, everybody? Today we're doing this video sitting down because I'm injured, man. Let this be an example that kickball and karaoke don't mix. And I wish I could tell you why, but I woke up this morning like not being able to move my index finger, and I was like, what the hell happened? I have no idea. Now I have to wear this, which prevents me from doing a lot of things like 7 steps on how to tell when somebody is lying. Let's do it. They say that a person's demeanor or their voice radically changes. Oftentimes, what they do in these interrogation rooms is they ask the person a very simple question at the beginning, like, what is your full name? Or, where do you live? And then they'll start to get into what you might be lying about, and that's when everything changes.
My name's Dan. I live in Texas. What?
I didn't do it! Look, I swear I flushed a toilet. I don't care if I was the only one there at the time. Anybody could have dropped that dude. That's disgusting. No. Oh, shit! Now you gotta be careful because some people are naturally animated when they talk. I'm not like this all the time, otherwise people would freaking hate me. I'm just like, what's up, guys? You wanna play some kickball? Great, well I have 7 steps on how to win. I don't know why I touched my wrist. They're not telling the truth if their tone of voice abruptly changes like that. 2, the person has an answer for everything. Now you ask a person what they did Wednesday of last week. They're gonna have to pause and think, If the person has an answer instantly, like, what did you do last Wednesday? I can tell you that I didn't punch that guy in the face. Most likely they've already thought of it in their head on what they're gonna say, so they're probably lying. 3, hand-to-face activity. Now, it often takes the form of biting or licking the lips, okay? Pulling on the lips or ears. I'm telling you, the dog is already on your lawn. No, seriously, man, like, somebody else must hit your car backing out, because, wasn't me. 4, check at how the person is smiling. Now, a smile can often tell a person's true feelings. Now, whenever you see somebody that's kind of sad and they try to pull a smile, you know they're sad or you know they're angry because sometimes their eyes and their mouth don't coordinate with each other and they're just like, yeah, no, I'm not pissed off at all. I mean, no, you won fair and square. Yeah. No, I don't care. I didn't really want to go swimming anyway. No, it's not like I brought my Speedo or anything. It's great. It's totally cool. 5, liars tend to avoid the words I or me. It's because they're trying to distance themselves as far away from the lie as possible. So, liars will communicate using less personal pronouns. 6, inconsistency. No, man, I walked to the store, then I stepped in your dog's crap. Remember that. No, man, I was hopscotching all the way to the store, and then I slipped in your dog's crap. Were you walking or were you hopscotching? So look for inconsistencies in people's stories. Last but not least, 7, too much detail. Oftentimes, when somebody's telling a lie, they'll provide you with information that you really don't need. I tied my shoe. Then I started walking to the store. I went and I saw a dog. I pet the dog. Made awkward small talk with the lady. I sneezed twice. The second one was juicier than the first. I then avoided every sidewalk crack because I didn't want to break my mother's back. And that's about it, yeah. No, that's about it. Now, too much detail can also mean that they put a lot of thought into this lie. So what they decided to do was craft a very complicated situation that might confuse you. So there you have 7 tips on how to figure out if somebody is telling a lie. Kickball, Thanks a lot for watching, I hope you guys enjoyed that, and I will see you in my next video. See you guys later.
Don't you let me go.